Hello friends, welcome to All Basic. Friends, today we will know about National Commission for Scheduled Castes. The National Commission for Scheduled Castes is a constitutional body in the sense that it is directly established by Article 338 of the Constitution. Evolution of the Commission. Originally, Article 338 of the Constitution provided for the appointment of a special officer for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes to investigate all matters relating to the constitutional safeguards for the SCs and STs and to report to the President on their working. He was designated as the Commissioner for SCs and STs and assigned the said duty. The 89th Constitutional Amendment Act of 2003 bifurcated the combined National Commission for SCs and STs into two separate bodies, namely National Commission for Scheduled Castes under Article 338 and National Commission for Scheduled Tribes under Article 338A. The separate National Commission for SCs came into existence in 2004. It consists of a chairperson, a vice chairperson, and three other members. They are appointed by the President by warrant under his hand and seal. Their condition of service and tenure of office are also determined by President. Functions of the Commission. The functions of the Commission are to investigate and monitor all matters relating to the constitutional and other legal safeguards for the SCs and to evaluate their working, to inquire into specific complaints with respect to the deprivation of rights and safeguards of the SCs, to participate and advise on the planning process of socio-economic development of the SCs and to evaluate the process of their development under the union or a state. Report of the Commission. The Commission presents an annual report to the President. It can also submit a report as and when it thinks necessary. The President places all such reports before the Parliament along with a memorandum explaining the action taken on the recommendation made by the Commission. The memorandum should also contain the reason for the non-acceptance of any of such recommendations. Powers of the Commission. The Commission is vested with the powers to regulate its own procedure. The Commission, while investigating any matter or inquiry into any complaint, has all the powers of a civil court trying a suit, and in particular in respect of the following matters: summoning and enforcing the attendance of any person from any part of India and examining him on oath, requiring the discovery and production of any document, receiving evidence on affidavits, requisitioning any public record from any court or office, issuing summons for the examination of witnesses and documents, and any other matter which the President may determine. The central government and the state governments are required to consult the Commission on all major policy matters affecting the SCs. Today's question. The 65th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1990. The 66th Constitutional Amendment Act of 1990 provided for the establishment of a high-level multi-member National Commission for SCs and STs in the place of a single special officer for SCs and STs. This constitutional body replaced the Commissioner for SCs and STs as well as the Commission set up under the resolution of 1987. Today's word. Schedule. A plan for carrying out a process or procedure, giving list of intended events and times. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.